The first version of the Overseas Highway was built in 1928, when the population in the Keys outside of Key West was likely no more than 1,000 people. That dramatically changed over the course of the 20th century, with the island chain becoming a major tourist destination. As the COVID-19 pandemic closed many other tourist spots worldwide, even more people are visiting the Keys year-round, leading some to question whether the archipelago has outgrown the Overseas Highway.
There's a lot of different cogs to this wheel. It's not just one facet. There's a lot of contractors that are coming up and down from Miami-Dade County, and certainly they add to a lot of the impacts to the road. There's a serious contingent of second homeowners that live in Miami-Dade, Broward, and maybe even Collier County. And they have, obviously, they're on the road on Thursday, Friday, and they're back up on the road on Friday and Sunday. Certainly, you know, we've seen increases in tourism during the pandemic. I don't believe that that's going to be something that's going to be sustainable, okay, down the road as more destinations, cruise lines get back opening up. So that should lessen it, and I think that that will normalize it.
We have overgrown, through population and tourism and traffic flow, the ability for this road to flow traffic the way it should be flowing for efficiency, effectiveness, and safety. I think we're almost stuck with what we have. We have to figure out how to make what we have better, whether it be some center turn lanes, whether it be some deacceleration lanes, reevaluating speeds, signage, passing zones, better lighting. So there's a lot of things we can do to help mitigate it, but at the end of the day, this road is only designed to flow so many cars per hour, and we've reached that capacity.